Cameraman, do you know what a gay sauna is? Are you a homosexual?
No.
Do you know what a gay sauna is? Do you not? Basically, it's like a health spa.
Yeah.
For gay men.
Yeah.
And you go in, you don't wear clothes, you put a towel on. And
they just basically go for health and wellness.
Bummed ridges.
Hi, I am Monét X Change.
And I am the Vivienne, and we are...
Sorry, I fucked this up.
And we are...
Queens!
Well, who likes to watch?
Like what?
Today, we are going to watch one classic British sitcom and one classic American.
Mm-hmm.
And we will see...
Which one is funnier?
Better.
I don't know, let's say funnier. Better sounds so shady. Which one is funnier?
Oh, you've seen I'm Fab, haven't you?
I've never seen it.
What?
I've never seen I'm Fab. I know, shame.
Are you serious?
Vivienne, I'm sorry. I know. Well, I feel so bad.
Well, for you then, and people who are watching who've never seen it, shame on you. It's basically like a satirical look at the fashion industry and the kind of PR world. It's just kind of the hilarity that ensues with them getting drunk, taking drugs, and not doing their jobs correctly.
Okay.
Which is basically what I do for a living, so.
Work.
I could probably sit here and quote this whole thing.
God, I can't find anyone I want to look like, you know. Oh, actually, she's not bad. Who's that?
That's Ivana Trump.
She's good, isn't she?
Yeah, do you think so?
Mm.
Looks like a classic bimbo to me. All that terrible blonde hair piled on top of her head. False tan. She's...
So Patsy was based on Ivanka Trump.
Word.
Skirt's too short.
Oh my God, me and this one are like kind of wearing the same outfit.
You are.
Look at me.
It's awful. I can eat as much as I like and I just don't get fatter. I cannot put on weight.
That's terrible.
I know a lot of people like that. That shit fucking grinds me up a wall.
Oh, and they love telling you about it, don't they?
Oh, they won't stop telling you about
it. Oh, I can't eat a thing. I can't put on weight if I tried. And you're just like...
Girl, they eat crisps. They drink soda. They eat ass. They don't gain weight eating nothing. This was the 90s where everyone was smoking inside.
Uh-huh.
Can you smoke inside here?
No, I wait. I love a ciggy inside. Do you smoke?
I do. Oh, I smoke. Not cigarettes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I love a ciggy in the car.
Got it.
Okay, no. I don't want to see a big movement. Just enough to get your head and your shoulders off the mat.
Right, good.
Okay.
Good, sweetie.
Here we go. And one. And one. Feel those muscles.
This is literally me in the gym.
The best part of working out, you can't do anymore in the States because they closed the sauna. So, you know, I used to like go to like a nice little workout and go to the sauna to have another workout.
We know what you were doing in the sauna. What do they call saunas? Like gay saunas? They call it a bathhouse?
A bathhouse. What do they call them here?
Sauna.
Yeah. Do they have a bathhouse in London? A sauna?
There was a few, wasn't there? Wasn't there? Yeah.
Really?
There's one around the corner.
That was
do you think it's open now? No, right? Well,
did you not know there were saunas in the UK?
After today, I'm gonna go do a little exploring in London. After.
Oh, I thought this was a gym.
Wow!
I'm gonna work out my hole.
The cameramen are like, not this girl. The Department of Health in New York, like during coronavirus, they're like, if you must have sex, if you must do it, use glory holes. Like our state publication was like, glory holes are safe. They help stop the spread of coronavirus if you must have sex.
That's always the thing. That's why I could never use a glory hole. Because I always remember my friend coming up to me one day and saying, girl, I'm mortified. He said, this penis came through the wall and it was the most lovely thing you've ever seen in your life. So we had a proper good go on it and did whatever he did. And then afterwards, the fella who the penis belonged to was literally like 97 years old.
Word! You have to love a dick that when it comes, it's just like a puff of smoke. Like, oh, I'm coming! I mean, also, I like low-hanging balls, so the older you are, the more likely that is to happen, because gravity happens, so I'm into it.
Good, I'll be getting filler in mine. Bit of Botox in the ball sack.
Not filling in your ball sack, girl. No! Vivienne!
Oh. Right, I'm having a really healthy week this week, Pat. I'm not eating and I'm not drinking.
Right.
A fruit, obviously. Just eating fruit. Just eating fruit and not drinking.
You can't go to France and not drink.
I'm gonna watch.
Oh, it's girl, you need to watch all of that. It's so good.
And I'm not having sex.
You're sure, darling?
Mm-hmm. Bother do.
All right. Okay. Are we starting now, when we land?
Well, I think I can safely start now. But let's say when we land.
That's me. Have you ever been to the Mile High Club?
No.
Yeah, me either. But I
can't
imagine
would. You being that comfortable. Like, toilet airplanes are the smallest, compactest things.
But girl, sometimes sex is not about comfortability. It's about the experience. It's like, I am, and honestly, it could be a thumb. But I'm like, we are up in the sky. The experience of just getting a nice moment up in the sky. I'm like into it.
Go for it, Eddie!
I will say, people in London, people are just walking everywhere.
Oh, they don't care?
Lights are green, you red, purple. Woo, I'm just gonna walk.
Hey, what the hell?
Hey, what do you want? What are you doing to her?
Let's take my friend to hospital.
You've
never
been arrested.
Why did you look at me when you asked if anyone's been arrested? I've been arrested a few times.
What's your arrest story?
Oh, girl, I threw a glass at someone's face, punching, but I broke someone's jaw. I got arrested in full drag. I got put in a cell.
In full drag?
Full drag, girl, yeah.
That's the fantasy.
This I'm is like, the
oh, officer, what cell is mine?
Come on, we are going. Oh, get up those stairs, get up the system, my darling, darling. Just give me a wedgie on my thong. Can you give me a Let's keep going.
Oh, God.
Oh, that's better. Oh, that's a bit better. Thank you, darling. Can you still see it? Is it still sexy?
Yeah, well.
I am absolutely convinced to watch AdBad. This is really good. So this was from what? From 90?
I'd say this was like late 80s. Into the 90s. Did you hear they were trying to do an American version?
I did hear that. Well, I just realized a lot of British shows come over to America and I had no idea. Like Dancing with the Stars, obviously Strictly.
The Office.
Pop Idol. The Office was here?
The Office is British first.
Girl.
Shameless.
Shameless was here?
Yes, girl. So you get it all from us. I'm 28 now, so sister would have been. I remember Keenan and Kel.
Keenan and Kel.
Sister, I feel like I was just a tiny bit too young.
Yeah, I mean, this is like one of my coming of age things as a kid growing up watching it. And like, it was a really funny show. I don't know how well it's aged though. I haven't watched it since I was a kid.
Uh-huh.
So we'll see. Maybe we're gonna watch this and be like, ooh, girl.
Look at the little animation.
See, now, I don't even remember. This is like the original one. There was like a second intro they did like after like season 3, I think. That was so different. Oh my God, Roger. Go home, Roger. I cannot stand when people with friends would come at my house and put sleep that way and put their fucking feet on my pillows.
Oh, what you call it, top and tail?
Hate that.
Do you call it top and tail in America?
No, we didn't call it that. We call it
someone else in America.
Which didn't make any sense. Because if it's to like protect you from being anything like gross, the genitals are still the same place. Like, what does it matter?
It's probably actually easier.
Honestly,
like,
though.
Like, you just say, oops, we started 69 and mum. Sorry.
Okay, I know this might seem a little confusing, but we can't explain.
How do you feel about the talking to camera scenario?
I like it.
I quite like it. I think it really works for this
show. I like it here, but I hate it in Sex and the City. Season one, when Kara keeps on talking to the camera, I'm like, this is so stupid. I hated it, but this is cute.
How would you feel having to, like, work with your sister every single day?
I think I would love it. Because twins have, like, a different bond, I feel, than regular siblings.
Would you do the whole switcheroo? Would you?
Wait, I have a twin. You know, I have a twin brother.
Identical?
Yeah, identical twin brother. Did you ever know that?
No!
Yeah, girl.
Did you ever do, like, switcheroos?
Oh, all the time.
Like, proper parent trap shit?
Uh-huh, yeah. No fucking twins.
Have you not?
You don't have a twin.
No.
No, I don't.
You fucker. I don't know whether you've been serious or not now. Have you not? You're lying.
I don't have a twin.
What are you lying for?
What are you doing?
We're going home.
Hey, you let go of my baby.
Hey, what do you mean your baby? Hey, watch that now.
Wait a minute,
what?
Your hand.
Minute here.
What? Dad? Mom? That girl has my face.
And how did this happen? They were, like, separated at birth?
Were they?
Yeah, they were separated at birth.
So is that not the mom and dad?
No. I think they're both adopted.
What?
You cannot ask too many questions about the 90s. You just go with it.
Excuse me, I'd like to speak to Marjay.
Is that Rue?
Is that Rue?
I am she.
This hair, though. Bitch, that hair is so shiny. I fucking love this tall bitch.
Its tits look massive there.
They do. He cut up two rugby balls and just... Also, this is so 90s with the top and then the spaghetti dress on top of it.
Oh, darling, that dress. Heads will turn.
Yeah, the other way.
Look at the room, not
is she wearing a flat?
Not flats. The Alaska of it all, girl, no.
I do love a 90s Rue.
I do too.
What's the first time you ever came across drag?
The first time, well, so I grew up in New York City. I went to school in New York City. And when I would take the train to school, I would get off on the train at like 8 o'clock in the morning and I would see queens getting on the train, I'm assuming from the night before, like looking crazy. And I remember seeing them like, these people are so weird. Why are they dressed like that? Yeah, yeah, yeah. And now cut to.
Now, hello.
Hello. Hello, hello, hello. This is the one I remember. It got real jazzy. It's like season. Come on, choreo.
I do my own style in my own time.
Girl.
Look at that 90s choreo.
Girl, right? So 90s.
Meet TJ Henderson. He's your tutor.
Staring at. Let's hit the books.
Uh-uh. It's so crazy how fashion comes back around. Literally, what we're watching, that's what I see everyone wearing in the streets.
You're
now.
Literally wearing like a sister-sister outfit.
Right? I am, girl. Like,
I feel like Sansi from Greece.
If you could be in any 90s sitcom, which one would it be?
Absolutely Fabulous.
Ab-fab?
Yeah. I was in the movie.
Oh, word.
For like 3 seconds. I was all made up because we got the script and then we did the whole scene and they were like, Vivian, can you stand at the back of the bar? And you saw like a bit of my wig at the end of the scene and then heard my line. I was like, but we were sat in the premiere and my scene just came up and I was just like this to my friend. I went, I was fuming.
That was me with Madonna. I was supposed to be in this Madonna God Control video. You know, they like jazz you up. They're like, Madonna personally picked you.
She didn't have a fucking
she
clue.
She saw you and she wanted you, Monet. You're the one. I'm the director, I'm telling you. She loves you, girl. I was like, work, Madonna's living for me. Girl, there all day, 12 hours on set for a music video, dancing, chorus, ga-ga-ga. I was in the video for maybe 1.5 seconds. It was like... I didn't meet her though. She's like this tall.
Yeah.
And her ass looked crazy. She
was
just,
that when she just had it all
she
filled?
She had just got it freshly pumped. It looked crazy.
What kind of party is it?
A slime party!
They loved slime in the 90s, didn't they?
They did.
Anything with the kids on telly, just throw slime at them.
Honestly, they should be a drag race thing. They should slime us on the show. Like every time like you're about to get eliminated, whoever goes going home, could you imagine? The most humiliated you ever be in your life. I will say overall, I think I would give it to British comedy here. I laughed more. Like Sister Sister is good, but I laughed more in Ab Fab.
I feel like British like sketch comedy, it's like kind of like laugh a minute. Whereas American comedy is more like the story is funny.
Yeah.
Whereas I think British just kind of do anything for a laugh.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you all for watching. I'm Monét X Change.
And I am the Vivienne, and we will see you next time. Mwah! Mm-hmm.